Hey there. Today I'm going to show you how to set up a Slack bot and integrate it into n8n to be able to have a conversation with your workflow or to be able to process things through n8n. So let me just show you real quick how it works. Hey, Roger, how are you doing today? All right, I'm sending a message to my bot. We should see it pop up here. All right, so he pops up and then Roger will respond in just a moment. And I'm doing quite well, thank you. Just another day in the world of business and charm. How about you? Now, that's being run through a workflow of mine, and this is not, we're doing Slack bots. So we're gonna change the name to Slack bots. All right, so it essentially is a workflow that looks like this. This is not the same workflow I was just doing. I'm just gonna show you how to set it up from scratch, all right? The workflow that Roger is working on is quite complex. So we're just gonna do something nice and simple. So to begin, we have to have Slack. So you need Slack. Please have it already set up. I'm not gonna show you how to actually set up Slack. That's something that you can go figure out how to do yourself. I'm gonna create a channel, n8n test channel, that we're gonna do this new test out of. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and create new credentials in Slack for n8n. Now I need an access token. Where do I get my access token? Well, to do that, just look, you know, search for Slack API, and this is how you create bots in Slack. I'm gonna go ahead here. You'll see some of the bots that I have, but we're gonna head and create a new app. Now, again, you need Slack. If you don't have Slack, it's not gonna work. So have Slack, and then you'll be able to see all this. Create a new app. We're gonna create it from scratch. I'm gonna do n8n test app. We'll pick a workspace, just put this in my business. Create it. All right, so now we have all these credentials. What do I do with all of this? Is any of this important? Not particularly, actually. So there's a little bit of a couple hoops we have to jump through to get this to work. So first, I want you to come down to OAuth and permissions. All right, we're gonna come to OAuth and permissions. We're gonna set up scopes. We're gonna add scopes first. All right, first thing we do. So we're gonna do, these are the ones I like. Some of these are required. I don't remember exactly which are the ones that are required, but if you just go ahead and include all of the ones that I'm currently including, you will have no problem setting this up. If you do not include the ones that are required, your bot will not work and it'll drive you insane. It took me like a day and a half to really figure this part out. It was just such a pain in the butt. So this should get you by. It lets the bot read the channels. It checks the past history. If it gets mentioned, it'll hear itself. It can write into the chat. It can read files, and that's how I was able to do the voice command. It was able to read the file. Let's do groups history. I do groups read. We're gonna do incoming webhooks, and then finally, if my scroll wheel will work, we will do users read. Okay. Now, once we have all of those, we're going to come up here. I'm going to go to install to Carlton Family Corporation or to your business. Let's pick a channel for this to work out of to start. I got my n8n. Wait a second. What am I clicking here? Requires a channel to post. So where's my n8n chess channel? Okay. I'm going to allow that. Okay, but we're not quite done. Now, this is the n8n test app, right? Before I do too much else, let's, no, I don't want that. I'm gonna say hello at n8n test app, just to get it into the channel, all right? And go ahead, Slackbot will let you know you need to add it. Go ahead, add. Okay, now we're gonna come back here to our API settings. There's a couple things you can do. First, I'm gonna come here to app home. I set the bot to always be online. You can change some of the other settings. I don't think none of these matter. You can do slash commands if you want to be able to message it directly. So that's just a couple things. But we're gonna come here next to event subscriptions. We're gonna turn on event subscriptions. We're gonna do subscribe to bot events. We're going to add a couple bot events. We're gonna do message.channels. And we're gonna do message.groups. If you don't do this, it won't work. It doesn't work, trust me, I've tried. So, now that we've done that, we are going to do a couple things. First, going back to my OAuth, I'm going to grab my bot user token. And again, never ever show anybody your API keys. I'm going to delete this as soon as we're done. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to put this in here. Boom. We're going to save. All right. It connected, but it's not actually going to work yet. All right. We're not quite done yet. We first come back here to n8n. We're going to grab our webhook, our test URL webhook. Back here, back to event subscriptions. And obviously, it did not set it up right because I didn't save it. So back to messages.groups and message.read, message.channels. That's what it was, channels. Okay, now we click in here, put that there. I'm going to verify it. It says it's not working yet. Well, why is it not working? I thought I just put it in. And that's because I need to get it some data first. So let's go ahead and we're going to watch our n8n test channel. We are going to send a test event. I'm going to go ahead and save and do test workflow. I'm going to set this up too here. Where's my Slack? Okay, Slack. We're going to send to a channel, send to n8n test channel. We'll figure that out in a second, but I need users to ignore. It's under the Slack trigger. So we come here, users to ignore. I don't want it to accidentally catch itself again. So we're gonna set that. Come here, do the channel and just write test for now, just give it something. Now save, close the error test workflow, and it's going to be listening for something. So I'm going to, all right, we're going to go ahead and say, hello. Oh, that's because it's not quite set up. So now we're going to retry. Now it's working. Now we save. Now it'll work. I'm going to stop. We're going to test again. I'm going to wait for my message. Hello. And it caught it. All right. And it says test as an answer, which is an interesting response because that's exactly what I put in here as my message. All right. Beautiful. So it's actually working. My bot, my agent actually created a response for me, but because I was using test information, that's why it said test. So let's go ahead and actually get this to work. So what we're going to do is I'm getting my information. It's coming in, we'll do schema, coming in as text down here, or text up here as well. So what we want is we need this guy to catch text. He does, json.text. And we're going to go ahead and erase this, and we're going to replace it with the output from our model. All right, so now if I come back, I'm going to do another test workflow. And we're going to say, how are you today? And it caught itself. So, oh no, we're in an endless feedback loop. Stop. Try again. Test workflow one more time. Okay. We're going to now, how are you today? And it should respond with, I'm just a computer programmer, so I don't have feelings, but I'm here and ready to help. How can I assist? So it is able to respond to me. It's able to use ChatGPT exactly as if you were on the platform and you're able to do it right in Slack. Now, a few things that I'm going to show you real quick. Let's go ahead and come over here to this Slack node, the response Slack node. We're going to do the include link to workflow, turn that off so it doesn't have this automated with n8n workflow anymore. All right, so that sets that. Now, if you want to turn this and make it live, so you're actually able to use it in your Slack account, we come back to the trigger, webhook URLs, click the production URL, click the link, back to your bot, under event subscriptions, where we were, change, paste. It's not going to work yet because I need to turn it on. All right. And now we're going to retry, save, and now it should work just right. tell me what are carrots? I don't know. All right, and it responded with a big old response, right? And it's responding again with carrots are a root vegetable. Okay, so I see what the issue was and why it was creating an endless loop of responses. And that was because I was actually using the wrong Slack authorization. So back over here, when I created my Slack credentials for my bot, I just created a Slack bot button and I didn't pay too much attention. I forgot to switch it to the actual Slack credentials that I just created. So now that I've created that, I've got my bot back on. Let's go ahead and test it one more time. So let's see here. How long is the Great Wall of China? China. Capitalized wall too, since I did the rest. How long is the Great Wall of China? And it'll respond. It is approximately 13,170 miles. And it's responding as the bot. It's not reduplicating. It's not in this endless loop of it responding to messages and then generating new messages. The only thing I would want to change is let's go ahead and get rid of this automated with the n8n workflow. So we come over here. We do include link to workflow and turn that off. All right, and so that is how you create a Slack bot. I would recommend also setting up a second set of Slack credentials. So what you do is you come, that's interesting. So you come over here to credentials, create new credentials. You would do Slack, you're gonna do an OAuth, continue, and then you just connect to your account, just like that. Hit connect, allow, and now, you have additional access to Slack's API services right through n8n, not even talking about the bot. So you can use Slack as well. So that's how you set up Slack in n8n. That's how you set up a bot in n8n to be able to communicate with Slack. And hopefully that was helpful. If so, I ask that you please consider joining my free school community. I have additional resources. We give away free n8n workflows. We have technical support. We have a great community of business owners who are looking to implement AI implementation and automation in their business. Or you can join my paid school community for advanced tips, detailed tutorials, and direct support from me. The links are all provided in the links down below or in the description down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like it, subscribe to the channel. It really helps YouTube to optimize my content, to be able to show it to more people. And I really appreciate it. Hopefully this was helpful. Take care.